Good morning, guys. This is Kenzo Extra Hot Forex. So let's go straight to our daily analysis. So it's Wednesday. We're going to do NASDAQ US30, gold, US oil, euro, USD. So let's see what we can get. Here it's we'll just start with NASDAQ. It's messy. You can see that the market was just playing around with us. So, but you know what? We made some very nice profits. Let's see. Yeah, so I have to remove these ones. Remove this. So while I'm still removing this, guys, it's a very nice time for you to subscribe. So what do we see from here? By this, I think you should be seeing something. You see, I think you should be seeing something. What I'm seeing, okay, I can see that the market was just nicely moving up, even though we had some like very strong rejections, but we never had something that broke this the support that we have here. We never had that. So what do we do with that? It means what we can say is we can say that the market was just moving or above the support, or the market was just respecting the support. But if the market starts to break that, it's a sign that, okay, now it seems like the bearish momentum is very strong. So it means the bullish, which we're just pushing up, now they're just losing the steam. You can see even this bearish candlestick. Let me just zoom that for you so that you can see nicely. You see, so you can see that, okay, the market was just pushing higher nicely here. We were still thinking about buying, but guess what? The market just pushed lower and actually broke the support. But even if we broke the support, guys, we also have a structure that we can also rely on. I hope you saw the structure already. You see how many candlestick respected this area. This is 3 hour time frame, or maybe just because we used to 4 hours and stuff. Let me just use to maybe 2 hours. So how many candlestick did they like retest here? I mean, they are unable to break this area. Look at this area. And look at this. If we go back there, you can see this is a nice, very nice zone where we can say maybe we should just focus on that at the moment. So let's do that. Let's clear our chart. Now we're here. Let's start afresh. So when we start afresh, you can see even before I draw anything, you can see that now you can see that what I'm talking about. You see, so if we see something like this, it shows us that, okay, the market respected this area, and now we see like thousands candlesticks, thousand candles also respecting this area, even if they're not really moving away from that, but we can see that the market is not going lower since yesterday, you see. So it means from here we can still have a very nice buy. Do you see that? I hope you see that. From this we can have a nice buy. So the other option that you can use is if maybe the market is not the market. Let me zoom. I hope you can just use this as a bar, like you see, as a zone. Don't use only one line because that can make you think maybe the market already broke out. So what you can do when you use like a bar like this, what you can do is if the market is starting to respect this area, it's where you can have some nice buy pending orders and the market will trigger those. Or you can say maybe the market will break this area. Then you just wait and see if maybe there is a retest before you can say now it's time to sell. You see? So yes, today we're just hoping that the market can push higher, respecting the support here. Or if maybe it's broken, it means we're going to wait for a retest before going lower. I hope you see that. This is a bigger time. It's like 2 hours, not really big, but at least you can see a bigger picture. You see, this is a nice zone. You see that? So yeah, I hope that way you can see what I'm really talking about. So if the market, or for you to buy, you can say, okay, Kenzo, just because you used to do this, just do that again. I just want to show you something. We can try to draw like some trends line. I don't know if that will make sense. Yeah, this did. Yeah, I don't think they will. So it means you just have to wait for this candlestick to close in bullish momentum. Then you can enter on the second one. You can enter on the second one, which is bullish. But remember, since it's still early, the market can just consolidate. Just look how the market consolidated since yesterday. So the market is just actually playing on the support. Actually, it's respecting that support, you see. I'm not saying maybe the market won't break. The market later can just break this support, it's fine. But at the moment, the market is respecting this area. So we can expect the market to push higher. So the best thing, don't just jump on the market. What you can do, just place maybe your buy pending order somewhere here. When the market pushes higher, then it will find your buy pending order. Then you're already in. It's fine than just for jump, because you can just jump. 1, 2, 3, then the market push lower. Even maybe if you want to sell, you can just place like sell stop. If the market keeps going lower, it will find your order, then it will trigger that, you see. So you don't have to just jump on the market, because that way you might lose, and we don't like losing, even if it's part of the game. So let's go straight to US30 and see what we can get. Even on US30, I think, let me use 4-hour time frame and see what we get here. This one, we killed it yesterday. You see, this one, we killed it. This was our entry. Let me remove that. Let me just use 2 hours. So this was our entry here. Then here was our take profit, but yeah, this was very nice. But remember, we can't always get moves like this. When we get happy, when we celebrate, when we made like quick profit with this like crazy candlestick, remember, the market won't always give you moves like this. Sometimes you have to stick with candlesticks which they just consolidate. That small profit is enough. So because some people, when they seen something like this happened yesterday, even tomorrow when you give them signal, they will just wait for the market to give them something like this, which will not happen like every day. So whatever the market gives you guys, whether it's few pips, whatever, try to take that out, you see. So let's see. When I say out, take out, I'm not saying withdraw. I'm just saying you can just take the profit. I mean, don't wait for the market to go against you. So here we have, since we had that structure, this is a different one, obviously. I don't think it will match with this. So what do we do from this? It means we just have to wait, because I don't see any, let me just remove this. I don't see any good structure at the moment, which means we can just wait for this, for the market maybe to reach somewhere here before we can say we can go higher again. We can draw maybe some trends line, which I think they will be like, let's see, I don't know, just trying to get this thing right. Actually, you have to get the structures. You just have to try to connect and see if maybe you get something. But we don't have to force, because if you force to try to connect everything, mostly the market will allow you to do that, because there are so many candlesticks. So you end up getting like, you're able to connect several candlesticks, even if they don't really make sense, you see. So I don't know if this will make sense, but let's wait and see, because this is not really perfect. But I think maybe if the market is really respect here, we can now know, okay, this is really making sense now, you see. Then if it bounces here, we can say now, yeah, now it's really respecting our whatever that we drawn. So let's see maybe that on a bit smaller. I want to see that clearly. If maybe, we, yeah, but it's something. Do you see that, guys? I hope you see that, because I thought maybe this was not a nice area. So we are uptrending. We are uptrending. So my mind was like here. I never thought about this one here. So you know, sometimes that's why you should just do your analysis daily, so that if maybe you did not see something yesterday, today you can see that. So even here, maybe we might have the same thing. The market can do something like this before pushing higher again. But what we can do is, since the structure is not like 100% clear, it means we can just wait for the market to see to come around this area. Then we will see what we can do, maybe tomorrow or maybe later on today. You see, yeah, so that's what I see on US30. So let's go on gold and see what's happening on gold. Yeah, gold and euro USD, they still like bearish. Actually, gold is very strong. So before I go on gold, guys, let me show you some good stuff that we have here. So guys, we also have a robot which is $100. It's a very good robot. Let me just show you that. Okay, here, let's start with this. So we have a system which is $35. You can see the contacts. I've been preaching about this. So then now, why I continue, because there are so many people who really need this. If maybe you did not, you missed the first one, maybe you can get the opportunity. So if you really need the system, it's still $35. My contacts are here. Then you can just contact me. It's for MT4 on your PC, so not on your cell phone, but you can still get the notification whether to buy or to sell on your cell phone. So what's next? The next one, it signals for only NASDAQ and US30 and gold. It's one-time fee. Signals like you just pay once and you forget. The other one is VIP, it's $25, where you just get everything. Gemini 30, S&P 500, gold, all those things, then you will get them in here. You see? So I don't see the point why you don't join the team. So the robot is not here. So it's $100 if you want the robot. Then you can just let me know my contacts. You see my contacts, WhatsApp me or Telegram me, then you will get that. Don't forget to smash the subscribe button. Since we are on gold here, I think on gold we are still on bearish. If you still remember yesterday, I said that. Let's see what we can get. Yeah, we are still like strongly bearish on gold. Since USD is very strong, so it means we're not going to buy, so we just only looking for sell opportunities. But with this like aggressive moves, we might see another aggressive move going higher, you see, because there's always like economic news that you should check, because that can also turn this movement very quickly, you see. So make sure that you check those economic news. You can check them on let's say it's on investing.com, Forex Factory, and other calendars where you can just get the economic news that you want. So okay, yesterday as I said, I will show you the results and I forgot, so let me show you that before we can, because see on gold, obviously there's nothing we can do. Everything is still fine. It means we have to wait for the market to reach here before we can say now it's gonna go down. So let's, maybe before I show you the results, maybe you can even go to a bit smaller. But the market is just consolidating, guys. The market is just consolidating, which means we might see something. We might see something, because now the gold is saying, no, I'm no longer going lower. I'm tired of doing that. You can see since this rebound here, now gold is no longer it's not trying to go up anytime. You can see that if you draw maybe something like this, you can see that actually this thing is trying to go up, even if we have a resistance here. But it can be broken. Anything can be broken. So anything except it's possible, guys. So let me show you their results. These results were in my group. I sent them in my Telegram group. You can see this group here. You can find some good stuff in here, guys. I also sent the signals in here. Stuff like that, even the free robots, stuff like that. So if you want to join the group, my Telegram, where you can able to talk to me very quickly. So here are the results. You can see that I was talking about oil. You see this oil we bought like few days ago. You see, you bought only this ones we just bought. I think I no longer remember, but they were very high yesterday, so everything was nice yesterday. So oil, I was talking about oil because we bought it on the support, remember? Yeah, so you know what to do if you want to join the team. Let's go straight to oil. Okay, here is oil, guys. Here is oil. So you can see that, okay, since we got it here, actually this move, actually this downtrend move, now has changed. So it means we're going to just go up. If you still remember yesterday, I said it's not easy to draw a trend now, at the moment. So let's just go. I've drawn something, if you still remember. I've drawn something from, I don't know if it's from here. And I said if it was somewhere here, if it can reach here, then we can say now this is a perfect trend, uptrend, where we can just wait for the market to reach this area, then we just buy when on the higher lows, you see. Easy as that. So let me just draw that, because now I can see it's confirming with whatever that I was saying. But remember, the market won't just confirm with you every day. If it doesn't, it's fine, guys. You can't always be right. Don't just put yourself in a like crazy pressure and thinking maybe you are not good. You are good. Just try to make sure your mindset is set for this market, because the market will just punch you. So you should able to defend yourself. Don't just kill yourself trying to get everything right. So you see how this support is now, because now before we had this downtrend, here it's a support. Now the market is uptrending, so we drawn our uptrend support line. So you can see this was the first, second, now the third one. Actually, we're supposed to get it here, because we've seen the first candlestick. Actually, we can still add the first candlestick. Actually, when it was opening, the second one, we're supposed to enter, you see, especially on 15 minutes, not on an hour. So this one is a bit like few pips away, but if maybe it pushes lower, we can just get it. Maybe it can push higher again before coming back again, and we can still scale up, you see. That's what we call scaling up. You wait for the market to give you that smaller rejection, but the bigger picture is, you know that it's just a rejection. The market is on a very nice bullish momentum. Then you just keep scaling it, and it will just keep going up. I hope you understand that, you see. So we expect something to happen like this, the market to do something like this. Don't confuse yourself, guys, with so many things. Maybe, let's say, moving averages, they do this. Sometimes they don't confirm with whatever that you do. Hey, guys, just draw only these two lines, you're done. Only two lines, you're done. You're focusing on this area. You don't have to mess up your chart. I'm not saying it's wrong to use indicators, but sometimes people, they overuse them, so they can't even see the candlesticks. So it's really bad, guys. Okay, so let's go straight to Euro USD. Euro USD has been selling, guys. It's been selling. Where is Euro USD? Is this thing selling? This thing is selling, and I'm also using a robot on this thing. So my robot is on negative now, because it's just keeping going lower. But where a small bounce back is going to be nice. We're going to have some nice profits. So let's start with 4 hour time frame. Here we similar, Euro USD is quite similar to gold, actually, the moves, because it's euro against dollar, and on gold, it's gold against dollar. So the moves will always be the similar. See what I was talking about. So let's make this outer. or we can even go on an hour and just to show you. You see what I was talking about? We are still actually, this is a very strong, very strong. This is a daily. This is a very strong bearish momentum. So to be safe, don't just come here, try to buy, because the market can keep going lower. But even if maybe there will be small rejections, just know that the market can still go lower since we are under this bearish momentum. And maybe this breakout, we might not see it anytime soon, guys. You see, I tried to draw something like a support here. It's still broken, so it means this is really on a bearish. So the best thing is to just wait for a nice sell. A small pushback. That's why I drawn something like this. A small pushback, then you can sell. Small pushback, you can sell like that. Easy as that. You don't have to complicate. So what about this one? This is a very strongest resistance. This is the inner resistance. So actually, the market will just create the inner resistance, because sometimes the outer one, the strong one, sometimes is very far. You see, so the market will just keep doing this. When there is another very big strong move, it can just go up. But when it reaches here, it can still come back again and go lower. You should understand stuff like that so that you don't really mess up your chart. Because sometimes people, they don't really understand when you have something like this. You have like so many trend line. Let's say I have my resistance and I still say this is my resistance. You should understand that this is a very strong one. It's the outer one. And this one, it's inner. But it doesn't mean the market won't respect the inner. But remember, the respect is not the same. So it can just respect this one. After it can just push up, then here it will just respect it and push lower again and create another inner trend line again. Then that's how the market moves, you see. So thank you, guys. Don't forget to smash that subscribe button. This is Kenzo Extra Hot Forex. If you want to talk to me, just check my description. You will find my contacts and you can able to talk to me. If you want the robot, talk to me. If you want the system, talk to me. If you want to join the signals, just talk to me. Then I will help you. Thanks.